Democratic Party, we were on a path to give a pass to a Republican that already had $1.5 million in the bank. If he had run unopposed, he could have spent money against all of our Democratic candidates and still had some left over to jumpstart his candidacy for governor in 2016. And that was a scenario I just wasn't prepared to live with. So I stepped down as chair of the party to make this run for lieutenant governor. Now, I'm definitely a team player, but I didn't do it to take one for the team or to throw myself on the sword. I actually saw a path to victory. But more important than that, I saw the importance of the lieutenant governor's office, maybe something that I and a lot of us had taken for granted. Former United States Senator Tom Eagleton said it was the best job in the world. He'd get up every morning, call over the governor's mansion, say, is the governor still alive? And if they said yes, you could just go back to bed. But in that is something that we have to keep in mind, because the primary role of the lieutenant governor is to be ready to be governor should the need arise. And so we need to look at the lieutenant governor's office with the same seriousness that we look at the top of the ticket. And I'm the only one running out of all four parties with candidates in this race that is ready to lead from day one. But I also have the strengths and specific duties of the office, because as senior advocate, I learned as my time in the state auditor's office the protections that we need to have for our senior citizens. And there is no better advocate for veterans' affairs. I came from a military family. My dad was a career Marine missing in action in Vietnam. And I will work tirelessly to make sure that all of our veterans and the military families get the things that they have earned and deserve the way that I did, because I went to school on the GI Bill. You know, things change. The guy with all the money dropped out of the race and bought a bank. And suddenly everybody saw this as a winnable race, but that is a good thing. We need to see these as winnable races so that we go out and work for them, because if we don't think it's winnable, we don't work as hard, and losing becomes a self-fulfilling prophecy. So it is winnable, it's a good thing, but that means I now have a primary. I have an 8-way primary where once, as party chair, I couldn't get a single taker. And we have to look beyond that for the November election, though. I'm very confident that I will win this primary. I have a 25-point lead in the polls, and I'm first on the ballot out of the 8. But, we can't wait. We can't wait to start working for it until after August, especially because one of the Republican opponents is taking his checks in $250,000 increments. So we have to start working now. I need your support now. We all need to be out there and work for it now and not 4 months from now. And I am convinced, I am clear about the way to do this, and it is with all your help. So I'm here again tonight to ask for your help and ask for your support. And I am confident that if we all work together, we will win this in November. So thank you all so much for having me and for everything you're going to do ahead.